collapse of the Mycenaean Greece has been one of the most vaguely attested and mysterious events of the Late Bronze Age. Mycenae, Pylos, Thebes, and many other wealthy palace centers were all destroyed in a time span of just several decades, some of them never to be resettled. During the Greek Dark Ages that followed, many of the Peloponnesian settlements would slowly re-emerge. However, the inhabitants of these cities no longer claimed the lineage of the Mycenaean or Achaean kings of old. They called themselves the Dorians. They claimed descent from the warriors of central and northern Greece that had accompanied the successors of Heracles in their legendary quest to reclaim Peloponnese. These ancient Greek traditions have prompted many scholars across recent centuries to speculate about what they called the Dorian invasion. Here, we will analyze the events that led to the rise of the Dorian Greek speakers. Special thanks to all our Patreons, YouTube members, and subscribers for supporting the channel. The term Dorian invasion came to prominence in the 19th century among the classical scholars, who sought to explain the origins of the speakers of Doric Greek dialect in southern Greece. The speakers of Doric proper in the classical times chiefly inhabited the regions of Argolis, Laconia and Messenia on Peloponnese, the cities of Corinth and Megara, as well as Crete, Rhodes, several smaller islands, several colonies in Asia Minor, and numerous other Dorian colonies across the Mediterranean. In addition to these, the speakers of the related northwestern Greek dialect lived in Elis, Delphi, and mountainous areas of central and northern Greece, with its variants in Epirus and as far as Macedon to the north. Also closely related was the speech of the Achaeans in northern Peloponnese, whose dialect was similar to Doric, although with its own, presumably more archaic, elements. Other Greek dialects were Aeolian, Ionian, and Arcado-Cypriot, perhaps the most direct successor to the Mycenaean Greek. According to the theory of the Dorian invasion, the Doric speakers conquered Peloponnese, either causing or arriving after the collapse of the Mycenaean authority. The remnants of the Mycenaean population, which would have been the Achaeans, thus supposedly fell under the Dorian rule. The theory itself was based on ancient Greek tradition, which tells of the so-called return of the Heraclidae. The Heraclidae were the descendants of legendary Heracles, who several generations after the Trojan War marched on Peloponnese and defeated the remnants of the Achaean kingdoms, thus seizing power for themselves. Their armies were led by three brothers, Temenus, Crisphantes, and Aristodemus, themselves being great-great-grandsons of Heracles himself. Their claim for the control of Peloponnese dates all the way back to the time of Heracles, himself a cousin of the Mycenaean king Eurystheus. Upon Heracles' death, Eurystheus exiled the children of Heracles from Peloponnese and went to great lengths across Greece in order to put them to death. Eventually, he is killed near Athens in battle by Heracles' son Helos, thus giving birth to the claims of the Heraclid legitimacy for the kingship. However, the Mycenaean throne was instead seized by Atreus and his brother Thyestes, themselves from the lineage of Pelops, which then started a century-long animosity between the Heraclidae and the new royal house of Mycenae. The Heraclidae themselves were reportedly allied with and possibly ruled over the Dorians, inhabiting mountainous regions of central Greece as well as parts of Thessaly. Dorians tracked their lineage to Dimas and Pamphilas, the sons of King Aegimius, who ruled in Thessaly and was an ally and friend of Heracles. In Greek mythology, after Heracles passed away, Aegimius adopted his son Helas, who was then given a third of Aegimius' realm, the other two-thirds being given to Dimas and Pamphilas. From then on, the Dorians thus consisted of three clans, Dimanis, Pamphylioi, and Hylianoi. During the reign of King Tisamenes in Mycenae, which would correspond to the end of the 12th century BCE, the Heraclidae made their final attempt to defeat the Pelopid dynasty on Peloponnese. Ultimately, they managed to succeed, defeating and killing Tisamenes and seizing the territories of Argolis, Laconia, and Messenia for themselves. Ever since then, the ruling classes of at least Argos and Sparta, respectively, claimed Dorian Greek lineage. However, the historicity of a large Dorian migration is yet to be conclusively proven. In fact, there does not appear to be evidence for any mass migration of peoples following the Mycenaean collapse. Furthermore, archaeological evidence suggests fragmentation and poverty in the subsequent period. The sub-Mycenaean pottery, which is dated to the 11th century BCE, shows simpler and less extravagant pottery production, which became increasingly localized. Such absence of clear indicators that would confirm either invasion or mass migration theory has puzzled scholars on what exactly took place following the fall of the Mycenaeans. The so-called Dorian invasion, as originally proposed by the 19th century scholarity, has been gradually falling out of the mainstream. Indeed, it does look unlikely that the return of the Heraclidae, as it was remembered by the ancient Greeks, could be rationalized by the Dorian invasion the way it was originally proposed. Perhaps the truth was somewhere in between. After all, cities such as Sparta, Argos, Corinth, and others did emerge out of the Greek Dark Ages as Dorian-speaking polities. In addition to the Dorian ruling and citizen class, all of these city-states were also home to the Periokoi, literally meaning the dwellers around. These Periokoi were the indigenous Achaean population reduced to the level of second-class citizens, who were free but held no political power. This clearly shows that at some point after the Mycenaean collapse, the ruling Achaean class came to be replaced by the Dorian aristocracy. Although it is unlikely that this replacement was a result of a grand military campaign or a mass migration, it is not only possible, but indeed very likely, that some Dorian speakers did use the vacuum and settled across the sparsely populated areas of Peloponnese. Archaeological evidence, such as that at Argos, does seem to align with this. Pottery and burials of the sub-Mycenaean period in Argos show that the Mycenaean tombs continued to be used, but also that a new cemetery emerged together with a settlement in close proximity to the site. The fact that one portion of the population emerged as the ruling class, while the other Periokoi, the second-class citizens, points to a struggle between the natives and the settlers, in which the latter ultimately prevailed, at least when it comes to places such as Argos, Corinth, and Sparta. In some cases, such as that of Sicyon, the two populations were able to find a compromise, with both Dorians and Ionians being represented at the assembly and able to hold office. In Messenia, however, the Dorians did not prevail, despite their settlement. The rulers of Messenia, despite technically descended from the Heraclidae, at least according to the tradition, eventually sided with the native population at the expense of the Dorian settlers. All the Achaean religious practices and pre-Dorian customs were constantly elevated in Messenia throughout the Dark Ages and archaic times, while the Dorian population was forced to participate or face consequences. This ultimately resulted in animosity and war between Messenia and neighboring Sparta. Either way, all of this shows that the Dorian emergence throughout Peloponnese did come at the expense of the Achaeans. The manner of their emergence, whether it was a conquest, a gradual replacement, or a mixing of populations, remains at least at some level a matter of scholarly debate. What do you think? Do you believe in the Dorian invasion? Or do you believe the Dorians really arrived only in small numbers and then gradually rose to power? Do you believe that the Dorian element was always present on the Peloponnese? Or did their mixture with the Achaeans give birth to the city-states of the archaic and classical times? Please let us know in the comment section.